All right, I'm ready. No, you're not ready. I'm ready, you're not ready, motherfucker.
And love won't tear us apart again.
Now this here's for your spouse or significant other. You were in love with the person, now you hate the motherfucker. Get the fuck out. Tell them to get the fuck out. You weren't looking for love when you met him at the club. Y'all exchanged numbers and went out for some grub. You waited 3 days, then decided to call. Went for dinner and a movie, then a walk through the mall. All you saw was the physical, a sexy individual. Never had the thought that they would make your life miserable. A couple more dates, consummate the mating ritual. Soon you will encounter the habitual liar. The sex was so good, it set your body afire. But why are you still with this nut? Every time they come around, you get this feeling in your gut. Wanna tell them raise up, but your mouth stay shut. When you stop to think about how good they fuck, when the sex gets old, you'll wind up stuck. So here's some words of wisdom that'll help you with the chore. Count up their IQ before you kick them to the door. It goes 1, 2, 3, 4. I had it up to here and I'm not taking no more. So get the fuck out. You gots to get the fuck out. Everybody, come on. 1, 2, 3, 4. I had it up to here and I'm not taking no more. So get the fuck out. You gots to get the fuck out. Everybody, now say you have a homeboy who's been sleeping on your couch for weeks on end and he's worse, walk him out. Get the fuck out. Tell him to get the fuck out. Now he walks around your house in nothing but his drawers. Dumps the trash once a week and expects to get applause. Let him stay at your crib, you was down for his cause. He was in between girls or in between jobs. But it's still no excuse for him to be a slob. Your girl stays mad cause she's cleaning up behind him. You can't get your calls when he's on the other line. And you can't get laid cause he has the worst timing. Knocking at your door at odd hours of the night. If he does that shit again, you swear to God you're gonna fight. But you can't kick him out cause it's just not right. He has nowhere else to go, but you're losing something. Control, wanna kill him in his sleep. God bless his soul. Maybe it's not that bad, but it could get worse. So here's a little tip from your homeboy Murs. Before you tell him bounce, do a countdown first. It goes 1, 2, 3, 4. I had it up to here and I'm not taking no more. So get the fuck out. You gots to get the fuck out. Come on. 1, 2, 3, 4. I had it up to here and I'm not taking no more. So get the fuck out. You gots to get the fuck out. Now let's talk about these old motherfuckers on the mic who were dope and now are whack and won't leave the spotlight. Get the fuck out. You gots to get the fuck out. He has some albums that I loved way back in the day, but as he puts out new shit, the memories begin to fade. When I heard about the comeback, I said no way. I was waiting on the real, the anticipation built. But with age came the degeneration of his skill. So I pushed it to the back of my mind and hoped in time those fine memories would once again shine. But he just won't stop, even though his album flop. Every time I turn around, his new one's about to drop. Make me wanna take all his old records off the shelf, cause the man I now is a shadow of his former self. So when he stopped on tour in my town for a show, I played a true fan and was in the front row. As he started doing classics, then he stopped and said no. We had to say we love the new shit before he did the old. I tried to count the countdown, but then I lost control. It went 1, 2, 3, 4. I had it up to here and I'm not taking no more. So get the fuck out.